testing. We all ready?
Yeah!
Did you like that?
Yeah!
We need to introduce you to Maeve Moran, Health Freedom Ireland.
Good afternoon, everyone. Can you hear me?
Yeah!
I'm probably a bit emotional because I don't know how everybody else feels like this, but this is incredible. Thank you all so much. You know, so coming out today, I know people have traveled from all four corners of Ireland to be with us because they feel they want the truth. They want the freedom. So I'm just going to say a few words. My notes just to keep me on script and not to delay you too long because we have some fantastic speakers following after me. So I wish to thank Glen yet again for allowing us to use this platform and giving us the opportunity to share our message and educate and inform the citizens of Ireland. I don't want to take up a lot of your time as we have some fantastic speakers, Dr. Marcus de Brun, Barrister and Senior Counsel, and also then Professor Dolores Cal on her side. Glen will be from Yellow Vest introducing three fabulous speakers on their side, but I leave that job to him. So before they start the speeches, I would like to actually just bring up something that I think has been very forgotten about in this pandemic, and just to bring everybody down a bit and to develop some reverence, we're going today to honour those who died alone without any family around them during this horrific, terrible time. The love and support of their close family members and loved ones. Not every one of these unfortunate souls died from COVID-19. No, they didn't. But they were still denied the right to have those they loved around them when they drew their last breath. Can you imagine how sad that was? How tragic that must have been for them and their heartbroken families. Having looked at the statistics from January to May 2020, Health Freedom Ireland gained these from the General Registrar's Office under Freedom of Information. In actual fact, the deaths are way down in the first 5 months of this year. If you take 2018 as an example, we had 14,380 overall deaths from all causes. That's in the same period between January and May. But if you look at the deaths in 2020 for that same period, these are all cause deaths. It was 13,449. And of that, only 1,390 were from COVID. So just let that sink in, people. 1,390 from COVID.
700, sorry. Less than half a percent.
For this, we closed down our economy. We have decimated lives and livelihoods. We have caused increased suicide rates and mental health and depression issues. We do not in any way detract from the terrible sadness and loss that death brings to families and loved ones. But do these numbers constitute a pandemic?
Never, never, never.
And do these numbers constitute shutting down society? Do these numbers constitute removing every pleasure of Irish people? Gathering in your local pub for a pint? Going to a match? Church?
No.
Weddings?
No.
Christenings?
No.
No, these are really ridiculous measures, and I think people are beginning to wake up and realize it has to stop. Yeah. news that's blasted out daily about increased infection rates that is driving the Irish people into absolute terror and fear. But they never actually classify if these people are in hospital or if they're even sick. We're never told the actual symptoms. We don't know how seriously ill or if they're sick at all. So we need to draw the public's attention to these facts, as so much scaremongering has been generated by the mainstream media. And it has created a massive amount of fear and confusion around this virus. These